Join Douglas McMillan every Sunday afternoon at 2 for an hour of music and song from the Celtic nations and beyond. In traditional and modern styles and in languages both native and adopted, hear the Celtic world brought right to your home through the magic of radio. That's Celtic World, Sundays at 2 on Otago Access Radio, 105.4 FM and 1575 AM, and online at www.oar.org.nz.
Hello and welcome to Celtic World. I'm your host, Douglas McMillan. You've just heard the Whistlebinkies with the Loch Ness Monster. Of all the instruments used in Celtic music, perhaps the most iconic is the bagpipe. Although the bagpipe was taken up by the Celtic peoples with great relish, it was not their invention. Its origins are uncertain, but the bagpipe seems to have been developed in the Middle East by 100 BC. It was certainly around in Roman times. In fact, it was the Romans who brought the bagpipe to Britain. Of all the types of bagpipe, the most iconic is certainly the double-reeded and triple-drone Great Highland bagpipe. It is easy to imagine the pipe skirling as hordes of Caledoni swarmed up to Hadrian's Wall to attack the Roman garrisons and camped there.
We'll be right back.
That was Albanac with The Gale, a somewhat romanticised mixture of tribal drumming and bagpipe because, as is often the case, history is far more prosaic. The Caledoni of the Roman era did not use the bagpipe. Indeed, the Gaels of Delriada in the 6th and 7th century did not use the bagpipe. It is even unlikely that the armies of William Wallace of Braveheart fame or those of Robert the Bruce in the late 13th and early 14th centuries ever employed the bagpipe. The truth is that the earliest definitive account of Scots employing the bagpipe in warfare does not appear until 1396, in records relating to the Battle of the North Inch, known also as the Battle of the Clans, where for the first time war pipes were described being carried into battle. Once introduced, however, the bagpipe soon replaced the trumpet as the primary musical instrument used in military context in Scotland. From the mid-17th century, increasing numbers of Scottish soldiers were incorporated into the British Army, and along with them came the bagpipe, which was organised, with drums, into regimental bands. Here are the pipes and drums of the Royal Scots Dragoon Guards playing the Green Hills of Tyrol. Use of the Great Highland Bagpipe has become widespread, not only within the armies of other nations, but also police force bands, among others. At the end of the Second World War, the newly liberated Bretons were inspired to create their own bands called Bagads, after witnessing the pipe bands of the Scottish regiments. Bagads differ from Scottish pipe bands by the addition of an oboe-like instrument, the bombard, and there is a greater emphasis on the evolution of the music as opposed to the Scottish emphasis on traditional tunes. Bagads use the Great Highland Bagpipe, which the Bretons call the Biniu Bra. We'll be right back. was Bagad Kempo with Kopanica. Bagpipes, or pibau cwd, have been played in Wales since the 14th century and differ from the Great Highland bagpipe in that they can have either single or double reeded chanters and have only a single drone instead of three. Here's Kerry Rees-Matthews with Erthagan Epibith Koch. Earlier we heard the Breton pipe band, the Bagad, and saw how it employed the Great Highland bagpipe, which the Bretons call the Binu Bra. A smaller native bagpipe, the Binu Koch, also exists, and like the Welsh bagpipe, has only a single drone. The Binu Koch is most commonly played in duet with the oboe-like bombard for Breton folk dancing. Playing the Binu Koch in this track, entitled La Mort d'un Capitaine, is Christian Anet. Thank you. You're listening to Celtic World on Otago Access Radio, 105.4 FM. That was the sound of Carlos Nunez playing the Raggle Taggle Gypsy on the Galician Gaita, another single drone bagpipe very similar to but slightly lower pitched than the Breton Binu Cot. Next up is the Cornish bagpipe, which differs from the other bagpipes we have heard due to it having two chanters. Double chanter bagpipes are more versatile in that they enable the piper to play the top half of an octave with one chanter and the lower half with the other, or vary the tone pitch with one and play the melody with the other. Cornish bagpipes are rare and quality recordings hard to come by. Here's an example of a Cornish bagpipe being played by Merv Davey.
Thank you.
All the bagpipes we have heard so far are what are called warm air pipes, because the bag is inflated by mouth. The other type of bagpipe is called the cold air bagpipe, because the bag is inflated by means of a bellows. The most well-known cold air bagpipe is perhaps the Irish Elan pipes. Innisfree Keol there with Star of the County Down. The Scottish small pipes are another cold air bagpipe, similar in structure to the Elan pipes but differing in tone. Here's Mike Katz with a set, Sunset on the Psalm, The Fiddler and Beyoncé's Welcome to Leith.
Thank you.
The last bagpipe I wish to feature is the Northumbrian small pipes. Northumbria isn't a Celtic area, though I could justify my inclusion of this bagpipe in the show by arguing that up until the early medieval period, northern England and the Scottish borders were part of a Celtic region called Hen Ogleth. Although there has been a significant cross-fertilisation of musical styles and culture between southern Scotland and even Ireland and Northumbria over many centuries. But the main motivation for including the Northumbrian small pipes is simply that they sound great. A point to make about these pipes is that they differ significantly to the other bagpipes showcased. Northumbrian small pipes usually have four drones and a chanter that is stopped at the end, which makes the music staccato in style as opposed to the legato style of the other pipes. What this means for non-stop chanters is that grace notes have to be included in order to give the impression of distinct note changes. Otherwise, as the term legato suggests, one note just slurs into the next. The Northumbrian small pipe is the only bagpipe featured today that has a chanter with keys. Anyway, here's Catherine Tickle with Raincheck. Next up, it's Fern Hill with Pilon Lerb.
Pilon la plume nous que Jean. caleçon mouton, puis l'enlève de mes occasions, puis l'enlève de mes occasions. Mon père a bien 300 moutons, pile en la plus menu que j'en, pile en la plus menu que j'en.
Time now for Dan Abraz and Dan's Frizzell.
Thank you.
Well, that's about it for another show. You've been listening to Celtic World on Otago Access Radio, 105.4 FM and 1575 AM. Don't forget this and all other shows are streamed live and are also available as a podcast. Just visit www.oar.org.nz to find out more. I'll leave you now with the Peat Bog Fairies and Tom in the Front. Hope you've enjoyed the program. Thanks for listening.